Okay, so in last class we tried to see different market structures. So characteristics is of different market structures. So we talked about different market structures. So we said we have four major market structures. One is perfect competition, monopoly, oligopoly, and monopolistic competition. And beyond that, it can be of different market structures like monopsony, bilateral monopoly, etc. So today what we will do, we will try to see how a firm decides its production. So what level of production the firm will go. So we have to look at that, how the firm goes to the decision. For example, if you think of a firm's production, always a firm try to maximize the profit. So firm always tries to maximize the profit.
Yes, sir.
So how to maximize the profit? The firm considers the cost and the revenue. So if you look at the firm's decision, for example, now suppose the firm is producing the first unit. So to produce the first unit, maybe the cost for producing this first unit, you can think of marginal cost. So if it is one unit, your total cost is, for example, 500. And if you produce two units, your total cost may be 750. So for the second unit, what is the additional cost? 250. Now the firm will check whether this additional unit can be sold out at least at this price. Because if the price is lower than 250, then it will not be reasonable for the firm to produce. So at every stage, firm will check that. So what happens? This is the marginal cost. And suppose the price of the product is 300, for example. So now, for two units, what will be the price? 600. Okay. So for one unit, you are selling 300, so P into Q. That means revenue is 300. If you produce 2 units and sell 2 units, you are getting 600. Okay? Your total revenue is 600. So, what additional revenue you are getting for this additional unit? 300. So, this is your marginal revenue. Marginal revenue means what? If you sell one extra unit, what happens to your total revenue? So, your total revenue is increased by 300. Why? Because the price is fixed here. Because 300 multiplied by 1. So you multiply 300 by 1. And now 300 multiplied by 2. Then for 3 units, 300 multiplied by 3. So 900. So here again, your marginal revenue is 300. So always the firm wants to compare these two. So when the marginal cost becomes equal to marginal revenue, this is the cut point. Firm stops there. And as long as you find the marginal cost is less than marginal revenue, it's good for the firm. But if marginal cost becomes greater than marginal revenue, so this is not at all reasonable area. So firm will not never go there. So firm will cut here. Firm will stop here. So this is the cut point for the firm. So always firm compares its marginal revenue with the marginal cost. So when a firm will decide what level of output the firm will produce, the firm will check at that level of output whether the marginal cost for that unit becomes equal to marginal revenue. If marginal cost is less than marginal revenue, firm will proceed. Firm will not stop there. For example, if it is a fifth unit, so marginal cost is suppose 30, and marginal revenue is for example 33. So farm will not stop here. So for 6th unit, for example, marginal revenue is increasing now. For example, 40, it is 33. Farm will not go there. So farm will stop somewhere where marginal revenue
crosses.
Yes.
Cross that.
Theoretically, farm will stop there. So maybe you will not find that point. So if you don't find, you cut at this level, so you are not going to that level where marginal cost becomes greater than
marginal revenue.
This is the core condition, necessary condition for a farm to decide. So what level of output the farm will produce, that will be determined by this condition. Farm will always check whether I will produce stop at the third level, fourth level, fifth level, 15th level. It depends on this condition. When marginal revenue becomes equal to marginal cost, farm will cut. So this is the necessary condition. So farm will stop somewhere where this condition is fulfilled. But the thing is, initially when you start producing something, maybe initially you may find this condition. So for example, if you marginal cost, average cost curve is this one. This is your marginal cost, fine. And your marginal revenue is here. Also marginal revenue is here. So you can see, if it is marginal cost, so you have one point here, if it is the marginal revenue, so you have one point here, where marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue. This is one point. You can have another point here, where marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue. So where you stop? Here or here? So that is the sufficient condition. You have to check. You will stop here or here. Because if you stop here, up to now you see the marginal cost is higher than the marginal revenue. So you are not just getting any profit. But after this point, your profit started to come. Then after this point, your marginal revenue or marginal cost crosses the marginal revenue again. So you have to stop, you have to choose that point where marginal revenue, the marginal cost curve cuts the marginal revenue curve from below. So to understand these things, you have to know what is marginal revenue, what is marginal cost, average cost. So today you have to know what is the marginal revenue and in what market structure. So what kind of marginal revenue the farm faces? Any farm, when they go to decide, the primary condition or necessary condition is marginal revenue must be equal to marginal cost. So up to now we know what is marginal cost, what is average cost. So today we have to know what is marginal revenue, how we calculate the marginal revenue. Then we come back again to this farm's equilibrium condition, how the farm decides. So what is marginal revenue? And what the marginal revenue curve looks like? So it is not meaning that always the marginal revenue curve will be the horizontal. It can be upward in some cases, it can be downward in some cases. So suppose you are producing a product. So for the first unit, and this is the price, okay? So if you produce 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 units. So for example, for the first unit, the price is 50. And for the second unit, again, price is 50. So whatever you are selling, the amount you are selling, and this is the price. So if you sell one unit, so your revenue will be, what is revenue? Revenue is quantity into P. So the amount of money you are getting after selling the product. So for example, if you have 5 units of bread, if each of the bread, the price of each bread is, for example, 50 taka, so your revenue will be 250. So that is your total revenue. So this is for total revenue. So this is total revenue. Okay. So what is your total revenue? If you sell 1, it will be 50. If you sell 2, 100. If you sell 3,
150.
So in this case, what happens? The price is fixed. Price is same. So whatever you are selling, whatever amount you like to sell, you can sell it at this price. It doesn't matter. That means you are the price taker.
Sir, I have a question for you, sir. Marginal cost or marginal profit?
No, no. We try to connect with the equilibrium condition. So it is not the, it was not the beginning. We just try to recall. So what are the components? What are the tools we will use? So now we started here to understand what is marginal revenue first. We know the marginal cost. In last class or before the last class, we talked about average cost, marginal cost, all these things. We know that. So, but what we didn't know is the marginal revenue. So we have to know the marginal revenue. Then we will come again to that point where we started. Okay, so this is the total revenue. And then 150, 200, 250, 300, and 350. So these are the total revenue. Now think of the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue, MR. So what is this? So if you change the sale of the product by one unit, what happens to your total revenue? What happens to your total revenue? So think of this, if you increase one unit, if you increase your sale by one unit, what happens? Your total revenue increase by how much?
50.
So 50. So this is 50. So increase by 50. So for this additional unit, so you have, if you sell only one unit, your revenue will be 50. If you sell two units, your revenue will be 100. That means for the second unit, your revenue is increased by
50.
That's why it is marginal revenue. So for the extra unit, additional unit, what happened to your total revenue? So for this,
400.
Again 50.
400.
No. Again 50. 50. 50.
50. 50.
So see, your price is fixed. If your price is fixed, your marginal revenue becomes equal to your price. So when your price becomes fixed,
so marginal revenue is the same as
it. Yeah, same. Because if the price is fixed, your marginal revenue will become
same
equal to the price. So if you find in a market the price is given, that means everybody is price taker. So what will happen? The marginal revenue for the farm at each level of output, you will find it is same as the price. So when the price becomes fixed, marginal revenue becomes equal to
price.
So in graph, how can you show it? For example, in this case, for each of the units, if you put quantity here, price here, what happens? For each of the units, your price is 50. Okay, so let us see. Your total revenue is equal to Q multiplied by P. So what is your average revenue?
Total revenue by
TR divided by
quantity
Q. So TR divided by TR is equal to what? Q into P divided by Q. So what is this?
P.
So average revenue and price, these are the same thing. So when you talk about average revenue, so you will understand this is your price. This is the price of the commodity. So, in this case, average revenue and price is same. So, when the price is fixed, it indicates that your average revenue, this is your price line. So, average revenue is same. Because it is a straight line, why? If you think of one unit, first unit, second unit, third unit, fourth, fifth, sixth, everywhere the price is fixed. Okay, so the line is this. If the line is horizontal, if you find a market structure where the price is fixed, that means everybody is price taker. So whatever the price exists in the market, everybody is selling the product at that price. The price is fixed. So if it is horizontal, what happens to marginal? Same. So marginal revenue is also same. So it is also the marginal revenue. So marginal revenue equals to price or average revenue. Yes. The same curve. There is no difference. So where it happens, if your price is fixed, marginal revenue becomes equal to price. So in graph, it will be the same graph, same line. But if you change the price, for example, if you sell the first unit, you like to have 50. If you sell two units, So maybe you can consider. So maybe you like to sell it.
45.
Okay, 45. Then for 3, not 150, maybe 135.
Parimit price
then? Oh, sorry. Only you don't small price. Yeah. So maybe 40, okay.
44 or
45. Okay, maybe 48. So maybe 45, 44, 42, 40, maybe 35. So that means, if in a market structure, you find that if you like to sell one unit, fine, you can sell it 50. But if you like to sell two units, you are supposed to, you are bound to reduce the price. Otherwise, people will not buy it. You may have some market structure where you have to compromise. So maybe the buyers are strong. So they are making the price. So you have to compromise with them. So you cannot take the price, even you cannot sell the product at a fixed price. You have to compromise. So if you find a market structure, we'll see that in what market structure this happens and what market structure the previous situation happens. So if this is the fact, what will happen? Come here. What is the total revenue? 50?
96.
Then? So this is the relationship. Like before. Before what you said? In case of marginal cost and average cost, when average cost was falling, marginal cost was below the?
Below.
Yeah, below the average cost line. And when average cost reaches its minimum, marginal cost cuts the average cost, equals to marginal cost, average cost. And when average cost is rising, it was like that. As long as average cost was falling, marginal cost was below. And when average cost
marginal cost
is minimum, then marginal cost becomes equal. Then when average cost is rising,
marginal
cost
is rising.
Yeah, sorry, marginal cost.
Sir, marginal cost is always falling the average cost. Always.
Yeah, always falling. In every case, any marginal function will always follow the average function. So it is same. So since the concept was not there, we tried to see. So if whatever the data is, it will be like that. So that's why I saw that this is a mistake in that. So now it's right. You see, at every level, when it's falling, 48, 46, you see that. 45, 39, less than this. 44, this is the average revenue, price means average revenue. 42, 41, 42, 34, 40, 30, 35,
5.
You see? So in every case, and also it should not be 41. I don't know why.
So 135 did it able to say 96 and 40.
Oh, okay. It's what? It should be what? 135 or 176?
131, sir. 131.
What is this?
131.
45. 15 plus 12. 12. Okay. So whatever it is, marginal revenue will always be less than the average. That is the principle. So when average revenue falls, marginal revenue will always be less than average revenue. It will lie below the average revenue curve. So now we know what is the relationship between average revenue and marginal revenue. What is the relationship? As long as average revenue or price is fixed, as long as the average revenue or price is fixed, marginal revenue will be equal to average
revenue.
But when average revenue falls, this is the price that marginal revenue
falls
will lie below the average revenue. So that is the thing. And on the other side, what we learned before, if you find this is your average cost, for example, for any reason. This is your average cost. Marginal cost will be this one.
Below that average cost.
But if you see that the average cost is this, usually average cost, the shape of the average cost is like this, U-shaped. So marginal revenue will be what?
Cross.
Up to this level, marginal revenue will be below the average. Then, this is the cross point where average cost will be equal to marginal cost. Then, when average cost is rising, marginal cost will be
rising before average cost.
Yes.
It still is below.
Yeah. No. Average cost is, when average cost rises, marginal will be greater than average.
Beforehand.
When the average falls, marginal will be less than.
When both are equal, then the curve is cross.
Yes. At the cross point, both are equal. So now we understand what is average cost, marginal cost, what is average revenue, marginal revenue. If you know the average cost, for example, average cost is 50, and you produced, for example, your quantity is 50, what will be the total cost?
250.
So AC multiplied by Q is your total cost, isn't it? Because total cost divided by Q is equal to AC. So if you know AC, know the Q is 50, so you know
2500.
No,
2500.
You see? So if you know the average cost, you can easily identify the total. If you know the price, which is average revenue, for example, 40, you know the price. If you know the quantity, 50, so what will be the total revenue?
2,000.
Price into quantity.
Price
means average revenue. So average revenue into quantity. So it is 40 multiplied by 50 is 2,000. So if you know the quantity and if you can identify anyhow the average cost, then you can know the total cost. If you know the price and quantity, you can easily find
total
the
cost.
Total revenue.
Total revenue.
Total revenue. So now we know all these tools. So we will use these tools to see how the firm decides its output level, how the firm reaches its equilibrium. So suppose a firm A produces something, so like for example rice. They are producing rice. Now you like to know where the farm will go. That means what will be the level of output the farm will produce. How the farm will decide it. So we said the basic condition is marginal cost must be equal to marginal revenue. So if you fulfill this condition, then you can check whether the farm gets profit or not. This is the condition where the farm will stop. Okay. So we'll add that. Farm will go up to this level. Okay.
Maximum.
Yeah, maximum. Okay, so now let's see. So you have this farm and this rice. So you need to know MR. You need to know MC. So for example, you know MC. MC is this one and MC is this one. Fine. You know the MC and PC. Fine. Now how you know the MR?
Cross section.
This is MC. You know MC because if you know AC, you can know
marginal revenue.
How will you know the marginal revenue?
Quantity levels. Quantity.
You need the quantity amount and price. So if you like to find the marginal revenue, first you have to think of average revenue. Average revenue is what?
The price is the average revenue.
So how you will understand the price is falling or fixed?
If the quantity of price are same.
How will you understand that the price is falling? So what you have to do? You have to know the product the farm is producing, it goes to what market? Is it perfect competition? Is perfect competition or monopoly? Or oligopoly? Or monopolistic competition? Why? So what is the market structure of this product? So if the market structure is perfect competition, if this firm is operating in a perfectly competitive market structure, so what will happen?
Price will be same.
All are price taken there.
If the monopoly, the price will fall.
Yes, if it's a monopolist firm, if the firm is a monopolist, then firm can make the price. So farm can make the price, fine. But if it is a perfect competition,
price.
So what will be the average revenue?
Scale.
This will be your average revenue. That means price. Is it clear? If the product goes to the perfect competition, that means this farm operates in a perfectly competitive environment where a lot of other farms are there. They are competing each other. Nobody can make the price. Everybody is price taker. So in that case, the price line will be this. This is the price line. You can call it price line. You can call it average revenue curve. Doesn't matter. So it will be like this. See, so what market structure?
Whatever. Perfect.
Perfect competition. Fine. But if it is not perfect competition, if it is not perfect competition, what will be the price line? Straight or
downward?
Downward. Why?
Price will be decreases.
Okay, so suppose you are a monopolist. So you have the whole authority.
Well, then price will be increases.
Okay, so we can take it. So, for example, since you have the power to pay the price, so you will try to increase the price. But you cannot do two together. I can increase, I can ask a price, for example, I am a bread producer, so I can ask 100 taka, 500 taka, doesn't matter. But I cannot decide what amount of the product will be sold out. I cannot decide that. That will be decided by the buyers.
Buyers.
Yes, buyers will decide. So I cannot make both price as well as quantity. Quantity will be decided by the buyers. If I make the price, or if I make the quantity, if I say that, okay, this amount of quantity I will sell. So then the price you have to, you have to allow the buyers to choose it. Because if the buyers are not getting the flexibility in terms of price, then you will not be able to sell the product. Because if I want that, for example, 100 units I will sell, then I cannot decide the price. The buyers will decide to buy this 100 unit, how much they want to pay. Or if I decide the price, for example, I think that every product, or I am planning that every unit of my product will be sold out at 50, for example. Then what amount of the product will be bought by the buyers? It is their decision.
It's the buyer's choice.
Yes, so we cannot decide both together, price as well as
quantity.
So if it happens, what is said? So what do you think? The price level will go up or down? For example, for the first unit, okay, I like to sell it at 50.
So what is the market structure?
Monopoly.
Yeah, for example, it is monopoly. Or it's kind of imperfect market structure, for example. Not perfect. Imperfect, it is horizontal. So what will happen? For the first unit, for example, the price is
50.
So if I look to sell to, I have to give some incentive to the buyers.
So
otherwise, why they will buy? No. Look at the
utility case.
Yeah, utility case. Think of that. Why the buyer will buy more? They will compare
expensive
with their gain and loss. So if you like to sell two, you have to reduce the price. So this, in this case, the air cap or price level will be downward.
But market has lot of seller, lot of buyer.
Lot of buyer, a lot of seller.
So why this is the dictates, the curve is flow?
Because if you don't reduce, because lot of, no, it's only one seller.
Only monopolist.
We talked about monopolist, because it's not perfect competition, monopoly. So in a monopolist market, monopoly market, what happens? The monopolist cannot decide quantity and
price
at a time. So suppose the monopolist is thinking that I will sell the product at 50. Then what amount will be sold out, it depends on the buyers. Then if you like to sell more, you have to reduce the price. There is no option. If you like to sell even more,
otherwise
you have to reduce.
Buyer not sold.
Yes.
Buy.
So strategy can be different. Sometimes maybe monopolist can maintain a highest price. So maybe that the rich people will have access, they will use it. So they will take the benefit from the rich people. So big margin they will get. Then they will think, okay, now I will reduce little bit the price little bit so that another customers, group of customers can be attracted. So similarly you can go down. The monopolist got a lot of strategy. For example, sometimes you will find they go for price discrimination. So in this area they sell the product at a price, and in another area they sell the product at another price. Sometimes they go for market segmentation. So divide the market. So they divide the market, they divide the customers. So a lot of strategies monopolist actually follow. Because they know they cannot make the price fixed. They cannot make the price fixed. If they are fixed, if they make the price fixed, what will happen? So they cannot sell the product that much. So they have to reduce the price. So this is monopolist. But if you think of oligopoly, what will happen? If they are cartelized, the line will be like this. It will be like monopolist. If they are colluded with each other, they decide like OPEC or De Beers. So the decision will be taken by only one organization. So then it doesn't matter. The price line will be like monopolist. Just like monopolist. Because even if it is oligopoly, so if they are colluded with each other, if they form a cartel, so you
don't have the characteristics of the monopolist.
Yeah. But if they are not colluded in a written way, that means they don't have a written agreement, they don't form any cartel, so what will happen? This line will be a little bit flat. It will not be exactly like monopolist, but closer to monopolist. But what happens if monopolistic competition? It will be more flatter. But all the lines So you will find, and what about perfect competition? Horizontal. You see? The perfect, for the perfect competition is horizontal. For monopoly, it's almost vertical. But for oligopoly, little bit flat. Because if you go in this direction, yeah, more and more competition you are getting, you will go there. And if you get less and less competition, you will come here. So these are the ways we can think of the air curve. So you can think of the air curve in these ways. So if you have these air curves, here, what is the marginal revenue? MR. This is your MR. But if you have the air downward air, what will be your marginal revenue?
Total quantity by total price.
So if your air curve is this one, where your marginal revenue will be there?
Average.
This is average revenue. So what will be your marginal revenue? What will be your marginal revenue? When average revenue falls, what happens to the marginal revenue?
Changeable.
Yeah, so marginal revenue. So all the cases of the imperfect competition, all are imperfect competition. Perfect competition and all are imperfect competition. You know or don't know, doesn't matter. If it's not perfect competition, all are imperfect competition. See, in imperfect competition, you will find always the air curve is downward. If it is monopoly, little bit steeper. If it is oligopoly, little flat. Monopolistic competition, more flat. And for perfect competition, it's totally horizontal. So if it is downward, anyhow, the air curve is downward. Of course, the marginal revenue will be below the air curve. So now we know the shapes of the air curve in different market structures. Now come to the firm's decision, how the firm decides. Suppose the firm is operating in a perfectly competitive environment. This product goes to a perfectly competitive market structure. So what will happen? So now assume that our average cost and marginal cost, these are this. So we don't think of this. Because for the market structure, this doesn't matter. These are related to the imports, so cost. So for the market structure, actually, it influences what? It influences the price. So if you talk about the revenue, then market structure matters. Actually, market structure doesn't have that much influence on the cost side. It mostly influences the
revenue
side because the price is decided there. So okay, so suppose this is, I don't know, maybe the curve. Yeah, this is, should be the minimum point. Okay. Now, if the firm produces something which goes to the perfectly competitive market structure, that means the firm is operating in a perfectly competitive market structure. So what will be the firm's revenue? Or air curve or MR curve?
There are two straight lines.
Suppose it's a straight line. This is your air curve. So what will the marginal revenue?
Straight
line. Okay. Now tell me, what is the point where the firm reaches its equilibrium? What is the equilibrium point?
When this,
where MR becomes equal to?
MC.
MC. So find the points where MR, MC becomes equal. This is one point.
Second point.
This is another point.
Sir, a point to
average
cost.
Average.
This one.
You don't think of average cost. So what we are considering here, MR and MC.
Only MC, no?
So why these two points, two values, MR and MC, are same? That means you have to find the cut points of air. MRL, MC.
Yeah.
So you have this MC, this line is MC, and this is your MR. So we can see here is a cut point. This is the MR and
MC.
Don't forget air, because air, in this case, air doesn't matter. Air will come later. What we need? We need the MR. So since MR is same, why? Because it's a perfect competition. In perfect competition, always the price is fixed. Everybody is price taker. So that's why MR air becomes same. Since AR is fixed, MR becomes equal to AR.
Quantity.
This is quantity. Okay. So this is cost,
price,
revenue. So whatever you, price here, everything you can put there. Okay. So see, this is one point, another point. Where you will stop? So the necessary condition is this one. So if you think of the necessary condition is fulfilled at A, also at B.
B.
So which will be my point? A or B?
Starting points are A.
If you think, if you take A, so for example the quantity is 2.
No, but
so will you stop here?
No, sir. There is a option.
Before that, the marginal cost was higher than marginal revenue. So it is not a feasible point. Okay, then you have to go
second point.
So because if you move, you can have this gap, which you are expected. Fine. So you will go up to this level. For example, 10. So what will be the cut point? What will be the equilibrium quantity here? 10 or 2?
10.
Definitely 10. So look at this point. Marginal cost curve cuts the marginal revenue curve at this point. Also, it cuts the marginal revenue point at A. So at A, how the marginal cost curve cuts the marginal revenue? From the top. So marginal cost curve cuts the marginal revenue curve from top. So you cannot take this point. The sufficient condition is you have to take that point where marginal cost cuts the marginal revenue curve from bottom or from below. Okay, so you have to take this point. So this is the sufficient condition. So second condition must be, so this condition is not enough. So if you just look at this condition, you are getting 2 points. So you will not take 2 points together. The first point is not feasible and the second point you will take. So what is the condition? What do you take here? The MC cuts the MR from below. So that is your equilibrium point. Now, once you get the equilibrium point, what you do? Now you calculate whether the firm is getting profit or not. So this is your cut point. This is the condition. So first condition is marginal revenue must be equal to marginal cost. Second condition is what?
MC cuts
the marginal revenue. So okay, fine. This one. And now, try to find the total revenue, total cost. So what is the total cost? So now you are producing 10 units, fine. Now I will check whether it gives me profit or loss from the 10. So yes, go to air curve. This is your price line, come here. So for example, it is 10.
So 100
price.
So price is 10.
Total.
And OU is 10, so it is 100. Your total revenue is 100. So what is the area? This whole area is 100. Because this is 10, this is 10.
Total revenue.
So length and width. If you just multiply, you will find the area. So this is your total revenue. Now, you need to identify the total cost. So profit or loss will be the gap between total cost and total revenue. So okay, so from this, go to the
yeah.
Where you have to go? You got the total revenue, fine.
Yes.
So you have quantity 10. So if you like to have total cost, what you have to get? Average cost. So from there, go to average cost. You need to have the average figure. Then you will multiply by Q, you will get the total. Isn't it? So go to the average cost. So you have this average cost here. Come here. So maybe 12. So this is 12, so 120.
More than.
Loss.
So now, your total cost is this one. The whole area is your total cost. So you see, this gap is your loss. So if the firm produces this 10th unit, if the firm decides to produce, but that is the equilibrium condition, firm will produce for sure 10 units if they like to produce. But with loss. It may happen in the business. In the beginning, sometimes in the short run, it happens. In the long run, no firm will go for any loss. But in the short run, sometimes, initially, short term means initially, sometimes it happens. You can have this loss. It doesn't matter. But you can think of another situation where the firm is gaining profit or earning profit. Like if you have the average cost is this one, marginal cost is this one, and this is your average marginal revenue. So what is the equilibrium point?
So
this is the equilibrium point. You don't need to identify 2 points now. You know what is the equilibrium point. So come here, maybe 15. So from there go to the average revenue, maybe 15 or take 20, okay? So 20, so the whole area is your total revenue. Then you have to find the total cost. So go
this
here, average cost, come here. So maybe 15. So this area is your
profit.
Now you are getting profit. In some cases, you may not have, this is economic profit. Always you consider this economic profit. Because we say that in economics, we don't consider the accounting cost. We always consider the economic cost. So you have the economic profit. But situation can be like this. Suppose this is your average cost, this is your marginal cost. When you draw the marginal cost, always think that very careful, that you have to be careful that average cost, the minimum point of average cost will be the cut point. Always consider that, because if you just find the minimum point, then draw the marginal cost, then it will be more accurate. Okay, so now if you put, if you find that your average revenue is this one.
Same as.
All these things actually cut at a particular point. Here, the minimum point of average cost. So you have, for example, 15. So your average revenue is 10. Average cost is 10. If you go to the average cost is here. If you go to the average revenue is here. So no loss,
no
profit. So this is called normal profit. You are getting normal profit. That's why we say the normal profit is a part of the cost. You are not getting any economic profit. So this is called zero economic profit. Zero economic profit.
Normal profit can work.
Zero economic profit. We talked about normal profit.
I'm not talking about break even profit.
Yeah.
Break even profit.
Break even. That means you are just covering the cost, nothing else. So normal profit is a part of the cost. You know that. Why when you calculate the break even, you are calculating your honorarium too or your salary too, as a managing director. So your opportunity cost is included. So that's why this situation is telling you that you are not earning any normal economic profit. So you are not getting actually in economics is any profit. So this is just covering the cost. But if you like to utter the word profit, it should be normal profit. That's all. Normal profit. Normal profit is not a profit. It is a part of the cost. So when someone tells that you are getting normal profit, that means you are just covering your opportunity cost. If you work elsewhere, so for example, you could have earned 50,000 taka. So now, above all other costs, you are getting 50,000, which is just your opportunity cost. You could have earned the same money working elsewhere. So you could got that. So this is the scenario where you can see that the firm is earning normal profit. So now if you have another market structure, if I ask you to tell about the monopolist firm, where the firm is getting profit. Usually monopolist, logically they will get profit, economic profit everywhere. So can you show how a monopolist reaches this equilibrium? A monopolist firm, how they reach their equilibrium? Okay, the same diagram. So for example, Q, price, cost, you have average cost curve, you have a marginal cost curve, fine. Oh. You have average cost,
minimum profit, this one. You have marginal cost, okay.
Now, what is the revenue? Average revenue. You need average revenue, marginal revenue. So if it is a monopolist firm, so what will be the revenue? It will be downward, isn't it? For example, average revenue is here. Okay. And marginal revenue is here. If you have the straight line, if the average revenue, it is not necessary that every time or everywhere average revenue will be a straight line. It's not necessary. If it is a straight line, then you can accurately draw the marginal revenue curve. How? So you will take a point here, so just horizontal line. Draw a horizontal line. Take this point and take the middle point here. Then draw a line. This is a marginal revenue. 100% accurate.
How can you get the point?
This point?
So no, this point, no? The horizontal line. The parallel.
Oh, this one. This will be parallel to this horizontal.
So how we decided this point? Sir, how we decided this point?
You have
this point.
How we decided this point?
Now, this point comes because if you just put the total cost function, total revenue function, then it will come.
Quantity
yes.
50%
come to this point.
Average revenue or marginal revenue
50%. Yes, average revenue and marginal revenue got a relationship. If you see the mathematical relationship, you will find the marginal revenue comes exactly through the middle of this difference between the vertical axis and average revenue curve. So if you look at the equation, then we'll get it. So we just try to use that concept here. So this is 100% accurate. But how we got it, that actually you have to look at the functions equations. Otherwise you will not understand it. So what happens if it is straight line? Only it is true if it is straight line. If the average revenue curve is straight line, then you will get it. Otherwise in other cases it is not true. So if you have a straight line, this kind of average revenue curve. So you can take anywhere, not here.
Parallel.
You can take here, it's a parallel line and take the midpoint. And connect these two points, this point and another point. You can connect these two points. That's all. So now, you have all the curves. Okay, this is your marginal cost curve. This is your average cost curve. Your average revenue, marginal revenue. What is the equilibrium point? What is the equilibrium point?
Crossing the point.
So you have A, B, C. Which is the equilibrium point?
Sir,
in
between
C
point.
C point.
What?
MR and MC is equal.
Because this is your MR.
MR.
So first, never look at AR or AC. Try to find where your MC is there and
MC.
MR. So first you have to identify the MC and MR. That's all. So this is your MR.
Yes.
What is your MC? This is your MC.
MC.
Okay, so forget all other points. Just this point is your equilibrium point. Come down to find the quantity. So for example, it is 5. Now you calculate or try to see whether it goes, it is earning any profit or not.
Price.
Okay, so go straight to what? The price line. What is the price line? Average revenue curve is your price line. Then come here. So maybe 10. So the whole area is your total revenue, okay, and then for cost you go up to
average cost.
So suppose it is 15.
Oh, loss.
So this shows you loss. Now you will show loss or not. Theoretically, graphically, you can show it, but in practice, the monopolist will not go for loss. Usually, they don't go for loss. So in reality, it will not happen. But graphical or theoretical choice. So what will happen in monopolist form? So when you will try to show the equilibrium of a monopolist form, so what you will do?
Profit.
So you have the quantity here, you have the price, costs. This is your line, fine. So you have to have the average cost curve, you have to have the marginal cost curve. And then you need to have the average revenue curve.
Marginal revenue curve.
You have to, if you like to write, draw it correctly, so take these two points, you have the marginal revenue curve. Okay? Okay, so what is the equilibrium point? So look at the marginal revenue. You have a lot of cars, don't forget all these things. This is the marginal revenue. And see where the MC, marginal revenue, that's the MC. This point. Fine. So find the equilibrium point. Suppose this is 10. Okay, this is the equilibrium point. Fine. You don't need to think of the farm will produce this amount, not more than this. Okay, now let us check whether the farm is getting profit
or loss.
So go from there. Go blindly to the average revenue curve, price line. So come here to find the average price. Price means average revenue. Price means average revenue. So find the average revenue. That is price. For example, it is 50. So you have the quantity, you have the average revenue. Multiply. You find the total revenue. So price means average revenue. Same. So this is your total revenue. Now you have to check the cost, total cost. You need the average cost, then you have to multiply with quantity. Quantity is there. Go to the average cost. What is the average cost?
This middle.
So come here, maybe 10.
So this profit.
So this is your profit.
Profit, yeah.
So this is your profit. What profit? Normal profit or economic profit?
Economic profit.
This is economic profit. Always, if you find this gap, always it is economic profit. So if you find that the average revenue, total revenue and total cost become same,
normal profit.
This is normal profit. Or you can say zero economic profit. Zero economic profit. So these are the two situations. One is the perfect competition, the average revenue curve is horizontal, so marginal revenue becomes equal to average revenue curve. But for imperfect competition, what happens? All the cases you will find the average revenue will be little bit vertical or horizontal, little bit flat. Okay, so it is if it is a monopoly farm or monopolist farm, you will find the average revenue little bit steeper. But if it is oligopoly, little flat and monopolist.
Nature is almost same.
Yes, the nature will be same, this is downward. So maybe we will not be that much strict because we are not digging deeper into each of the market structure. We are trying to have an overview because this is a very, what should I say? Elaborate discussion you need to, if you like to dig deeper into everything. So you have different market structures. In perfect competition, you have short run situation, you have long run situation. In monopoly, you have natural monopoly, a lot of other monopolies are there. So you have, what we said, bilateral monopoly, a lot of monopoly models are there. You have oligopoly, you have duopoly model, triopoly, so you have a lot of models are there. Four-four model, a lot of models are there. And you have, in monopolistic competition, you have a lot of things there. So these are the heroes things. But what we are trying to do here, because it's a very much compact course. So we are trying to have an overview on the market structure. And if a firm operates in perfect competition, how the firm decides? So it is getting profit or not? So it is in zero profit or profit, economic profit or
loss.
In monopoly, we can find the same. For example, if we are asked to find the oligopolist firm, how an oligopolist firm reaches its equilibrium. So if the question is like this, okay. So, okay, if the question is like this, how an oligopolist firm reaches equilibrium. So what you have to know? You have to know the average cost curve, then marginal cost curve. Okay. Then you will have to know the average revenue. Because if you don't know the average revenue, you will not know the marginal revenue. You have the marginal revenue here. Okay. So what is the equilibrium point? You have the marginal revenue. Marginal cost is this is the equilibrium point. Take here, come here and 10. This is the equilibrium quantity. And what is the profit or loss? So go to the price. Price line is here. So you have the price line. So this is your total revenue. So suppose it is 15. Whatever it is, this is the area is your total revenue. Graphically, if you don't even put the numbers, you can put A, B, C, it doesn't matter. Because this area is your total revenue. And then come to the average cost. So you have the total cost.
So some profit.
So yes. This is your profit. What profit? Economic profit. doesn't matter what market structure you are dealing with. You have to clearly identify the average revenue curve, and then you can find the marginal revenue curve. And you have to have the average cost and marginal cost. So if you like to decide, or if you like to answer any question like this, like in a monopolistic only competitive form, how it reaches its equilibrium. So what do you need? You need the average revenue of that firm, marginal revenue,
average cost marginal.
Put together and then find this point, that is the main point. Find this point, then you can calculate it. Go to the price line, you'll find the revenue, go to the average cost, you'll get the total cost, then you get, find the difference. So you have loss, profit, or... So these are the things actually we try to cover, because these are the basic things. Then we can talk about a little bit more about the particular market structure. For example, if you think of the monopolist, the monopoly market structure, or how monopolist firm operates in the market. So there can be some strategies like how they go for price discrimination, how they go for market segmentation. So a lot of strategies are there. So we can look at that. So these are the detailed things. So maybe one or two markets we can talk about in detail. So these are the basic things. So if you are asked to find the equilibrium condition of a firm, how a firm reaches its equilibrium, so you have to ask two or three questions. One is, what is the average revenue curve for the firm? What is the
marginal
revenue curve? What is the average cost? Marginal cost? And what is the market structure? So if you first you have to ask the market structure. So what is the market structure of this firm? So where the firm's products sold out?
Actually, the nature of the curve depends on the
structure. Yeah, market structure. Then you can find easily whether it is earning profit or losses. And second thing is, if you dig deeper into your market structure, we said if you think of a monopoly market structure, so what happens in monopoly? So how they protect themselves? We said exit entry of the firms into this market structure is strictly prohibited. How it maintains that? So these are the issues. And what kind of monopolies can be existing in an economy? What kind of monopolies? In some cases, for example, if you have lowest cost, average cost to produce something, automatically, naturally, you will have the monopoly power. Because you are producing the law at lowest cost. So this is called natural monopoly. So you can have this kind of types of monopolies. So in monopoly, you can have different types again. So if you have time, since we have one class for review, I think, so we can just go to these things a little bit. But for exam, I think you have a lot of things here. So a lot of coaches, because you have four market structures, four equilibrium, you had the characteristics, and before we saw the production functions, then we, I think before that we saw the cost structures. I think in mid two, we covered what? Elasticity, you covered all? Elasticity, supply. Cost, we covered in mid two, no?
No,
maybe. So we have cost, production, and market structures, a lot of things are here. For final, yeah.
Sir,
cost,
sir,
production,
sir. You alternate it, sir.
Yeah, cost.
Cost.
Production. Cost. Production.
Production.
Market structure, same.
Market structure is the favorite.
Okay, so market structure, you have four market structures. So you'll think of the equilibrium, how a firm reaches its equilibrium with loss, with profit,
cost.
With zero economic profit. So whatever it is. And in cost, we talked about the explicit cost, implicit cost, then we talked about different measures like total cost, marginal cost, average cost, so a lot of measures were there. And we use these measures here, these tools. So we talked about average cost, marginal cost, total fixed cost, average variable cost, average fixed cost, all these things. And then we talked about production. In production, we talked about the production functions. Short-term production functions, long-term production functions, we identify that. And then we discuss the laws, different laws of production. In short term, we found the law of returns to variable proportions. So there were four laws there. One was increasing, law of increasing returns to variable proportion, law of constant returns to variable proportion, diminishing returns to variable proportion, decreasing returns to variable proportion. For scale change, in the long run, we saw another three law again. One is increasing returns to scale, constant returns to scale, and decreasing returns to scale. So we discussed all these things, and then finally we saw the market structures.
You have also shows us about utility.
Utility, yeah. So I think utility, because it should come just closer to the theory of demand.
Yeah.
So you have a lot of questions here. So maybe we can put that, because we have 40 marks here. So at least we'll put, I think,
six questions.
Okay, we'll decide on that. When the review will be finished, so after the review, we'll decide what are the chapters we'll cover.
This chapter is better, sir.
Huh? Okay.
For perfect exam, sir.
So do you have any question on this chapter first? Any question?